which was used by a local food not bombs group. Food not bombs, these are the people which are collecting raw food, and they're making meals which they serve for free on the street. Yeah, this is the rotating composter. And this is one hanging outside. I really hope that we will continue as an organization to work on this and develop these activities further. Okay, thank you.
I hope that we will share our experience. Dennis is almost not here, so we'll
be here. Thank you, Matti. I will get back to you. Matti is actually now also in the process of organizing the Week of Creative Industries and the Week of Design, so he's really busy, but he can also tell us a little bit more about this type of community. Can you tell us, Matti said it exactly at this point, about how to balance the money-driven missions with the community. Sometimes the co-working spaces, especially if they're renting a space, as is the case in Croatia sometimes, they have to really keep their users. And you know, so how to keep really keep your vision and mission about developing the community and attracting your users, and on the other side, really keeping the sustainability of the organization.
First of all, I wanted to say I'm quite impressed by this moment in Croatia because they don't have any place, they have a big place, they don't have, but they do co-working. So it means it's a verb, you can co-work without a place, which is brave, I think. and I met you 2 years ago, I think, so it's, yeah, I'm impressed. And about your question, Darwin is based on rent, actually. Everybody rent a space. That's the economical model. We don't have any subsidized public funds. So, for example, for me, it's around 300 euro a month, which is quite the average in France for a space. I mean, you have a space. When you have a public space, managed by the municipality, it's very different. And in this space, it's multidisciplinary, which is important because we have some space in front based on digital economy, for example, web designer. And in this space, it's completely mixed. You can attract more people, in a way. It is also a way of making new connections between professional sector. And we have an association called Les Darwinians, the Darwinian people. And with this association, for example, we can apply for projects, which is work. We need to work to apply. And we have a good example here because we, thanks to an Erasmus Plus program, we have been able to develop projects. We are now the second year of this project, so we can get some money this way. Like thanks Dunja from Zagreb, who participated in the So that was a way. It's important, this association thing, because we could have host Dunja during 9 months. She got a grant to go to the association. So it gives a legal entity to apply to and to go to the board. So.
Money to revitalize them.
So we asked the potential users for what they need, what they want, what kind of uses we made of those spaces. So we made round tables and workshops, and in that way we can make the spaces available and useful for them. That is the interesting point. And from that moment, when we want to make projects with them, we used to ask them. The important thing is that you need to learn about them, and in that way you can grow up, and in that way you can make projects together, and you can create that community. And not only us with them, but also between them.
So just to link a little bit what we our two main the right and the left were saying, like okay, in Bilbao at the time that TAP was developed, I mean as now it is with different spaces, there were already a couple of co-working spaces, and it was a social innovation center too that was run by the public entrepreneurs cluster that used to put money and they promote us to become entrepreneurs. And so on, so on, so on. So mainly the SAP, the organization took a choice for having the modular space facilitated to the people that wanted to work there as in a private way, but with a communal space. And the public money that SAP gets for supporting or allowing the project to be developed, they use it to reduce the cost of the rentals for these entrepreneurs or users. So in that way, mainly, if the cost of the spaces are 400 euros a month, they pay 120 euros. So in that way, that becomes the facilitator, or they help enabling with some projects to come along. And that's how I will relate the SAP with the co-working, that they kind of use that money to host this working. And in the other hand, talking about the legal structure, maybe my personal experience is that we are not very friendly with the NGOs. Like we are more commonly used to say, okay, we make business, but the way we do business, we make a social impact. So for us, it's a slightly different. You don't need to be an NGO to do good. You make business, but you decide with whom do you work. And we look for self-sustainability. Something like that.
Okay. Thank you. Irena. you're going in Norway's transformation process to engage more and really create a community. How do you see any changes with the society process? When five years ago?
Yes, I would first refer to all of this because we have totally different, situations. Because all the associations, all 100 associations that are in social center Roche base only electricity that they use. So we are not sustainable. And all the new great ideas we all have together, it's very hard to realize them because it's just we don't have any capital to start with. And a situation like this is already 10 years. And now it's very hard when people are already used, they don't pay anything, to try to explain them that it's good that they pay because we will make some new good things. And this is a very complicated process, it takes a lot of time and energy. What was good is the space we are now in. This is the change in the last 3 years, because we opened some kind of co-working space that everybody can use it for workshops, for programs, for all activities they need. And slowly, at the beginning they were very skeptic about it. They were just looking like negative on this, but now we have more than 100 programs and more than 50 associations using this. We are managing the space, yes. But also there are some rules like that nobody pays nothing here, so we come again in this situation, we don't have money for cleaning. You know, it's really hard, and it's not only about, it's because in this part, it's my opinion, on this part of the Europe, it's our past, and we think on this way. So when we made the sustainability plan last year with Dunja, with Sonia, I always meet her, she really had this big discussion with us about all of this, and we started to believe her.
Sonia is on the cloud. Yeah. Sonia was on my forum.
And yes, we really talked a lot about it, and now when we are close to this situation that we really have great projects that we want to realize and that a local community is with us to do it, then maybe this change will happen and we will on some kind do this. But yes,
yes, as one of the mayor, which was my mother in the West, I think it's really important to understand what are the commercial components of what we're doing and what is something you will never make money. So I think the direction of having a hostel and a coffee shop is a great start, because in Croatia, in reality, we are really not used to paying anything, especially culture, which is like really big problem. Because the culture of the nation is also like really low.
Yeah, I think this is really important, and I would like to ask now Kaspars, what is the situation in your case, because you are also specific, you're artist renting and running the space, and you had invested a lot in the space, and now you have reduced, actually the owners reduced the rent, right?
Yeah, and we had left the space 3 years ago already. So. Well, I was thinking what exactly I would have to bring to the panel, but so I will try to concretize that my thoughts. So the one thing is which we are usually talking is about the premises and how to run the premises, how to maintain, how to run the organization, how to manage the things, but also here during those 2 days we have heard also a lot good ideas about the content of what to maintain and what happens inside the premises. And the reason why I long time ago, like 7-8 years ago, I started doing activities in the factory was very simple. My wish was to make my city where I'm living a little bit more colorful, especially after the past where when we had 50 years of Soviet Union and quite a depressing time. So of course it's still absent in our country, and it makes a little bit I think quite conservative thinking of the people, and also a little bit depressive atmosphere. And how to make it more open, more free, and more colorful is just to make some unbelievable things happening, maybe like a feeling like, that's not possible, that's utopia, but then you make this utopia live, and it's a lot of experimentation, a lot of risk. Sometimes you fail, sometimes you get really good response, and you can open some door and push some things, and so the content of what you are doing is really important. And so I'm coming from the art field, so I know that with art projects through the art you can communicate a lot of things to the people to think about in a different ways. So for me, these kind of conferences and experiences to hear what's happening around this is really important, and then afterwards I can try to inspire the artists from different disciplines through their art and communicate those ideas, because I think this is a very good media with a very broad audience, and yeah, that's the kind of main reason why I'm fully engaged myself in this development of art center. Even if we don't have our own premises, we try now to develop new collaborations and use the premises which are accessible and which are running by other people or institutions, also not only NGOs but also public.
Thank you.
I tried to tell this yesterday, but I just stopped my story in 2010, so I didn't have the time to tell about last 5 years, but it takes quite long time, would take quite long time to explain all the different parties we went through, and it's always improvisation, and it's not a fixed number of people who are involved in Total Doge Art Center. It's not a fixed module or structure, so we always try to adapt the resources which are available, and so it's very difficult to explain, but through all those years, maybe the most important for Total Doge Art Center at the moment is to provide a platform or conditions, supporting conditions for experimentation, which will be open for all kinds of art disciplines, and also not art, also involving people, professionals from other fields, to just not only meet and discuss, but also to learn to collaborate and experiment without pressure of some certain ready-made works of the workshops, for example. And another thing is, all those important issues which you see in everyday life in the environment where I'm living, for example, Riga's foods, all those empty buildings which are not accessible. So we try also to raise these questions publicly.
Okay, we have to move on because I think maybe ready for, we have only time for one more question. I'm looking at Daniela. How much time are you?
Why, when we work, we have to be in a great building, very serious building, architecture, boring.
What? Who said that?
Hey, Christian. We can be out of the box, but being in the box at the same time. And on other project, graphic project, with Tunia again, we had this artistic workshop or creative workshop. And that's very useful to
cross the barriers between people, profession, without language, could be with music, with, could be singing. We started that in Darwin with Christian to launch a circus song. It's just 1 hour on the between half past 12 and half past 1. It's very efficient to meet people, actually. Another way, not talking with I am talking from servers, but with the voice. So it's key point for me in third places and for working places.
And I think also by doing those colorful utopian things, it's really important to bring also some very, very practical and valuable ideas like this. Like what we just heard from the Berlin experience, like, what was the name? Yeah, I mean, these kind of ideas, if we can put in these colorful fairy tales, which is
more sexy.
Yes, but I think we need money. I'm sorry.
Yes, well, that's the next panel.
I think we are the most utopian person ever, and we make art, music, and lots of very great things too. But we need to be self-sustainable. And maybe we have to make like Fred, we have to make references and make them public to be able to quote and say, hey, you have to pay me, because I make cultural business and my work costs 2,000 euros a month.
I just want to say that, for instance, you haven't seen my presentation, but So basically, sometimes you don't even need a space. For instance, we are informal electrical co-working spaces, so if you want to do activity, we can connect whoever we want. Because it's more about how can you co-create certain activities and respond to certain needs of people, and how to, not push them together to collaborate, but how to motivate them to create something together. Because I think that's the best way how you can change things. Because I really think collaboration is a challenging concept. In Croatia and this region especially, because we it's familiar, but because of the hard economic situation, people are really too individual or egoistic, and they are struggling to survive. Also, regarding the money, I think that if we talk about the topic of partnerships and solutions, we should definitely reach out to the sponsors. I think they are really a great opportunity. I mean, for our events, because we are mostly event-based, because we do different sort of things, they are really open to support you, perhaps not always by money, but they can produce things, connect you to in-kind sponsors, sometimes give you money, so it's more about how can you learn to handle with all these different kind of resources and use them in the best possible way. I mean, it's a way to get money. It's easiest way.
I don't want to make it longer than
it
is. Basically, maybe a provocative question for Elena, because the way I understand the launch is that they don't pay any rent. And there's also, because you need to find some sort of convergence of the energy so that you can have collaborative atmosphere. I'm thinking about the project of the bicycle regression, where there's a condition to collaborate. If you work with the service, you can have the profit of that service. And my provocation would be if somebody had the position, maybe in collaboration with the municipality, to at a certain day start asking for people to pay a rent, what would be the impact on the community?
Can you put me in the position? What can I respond on? I think when you're thinking about rent it doesn't have to be something big or I don't know. There is also, we are thinking, because Daniela is more in this, about to produce the own the local money, like local bank, currency, yes, local currency of Reutz, something that you can collect. Yes, and then you have some benefits for it. I think because in this situation now, I cannot tell for sure, but like 30% of the spaces in Reutz are not really used, because nobody makes the control, because there's no rent, and there are not criteria to use it. And if we finally reach this point that we see what's going on, and we see really these 30% of the spaces are empty, and we can make some places like this that lots of people can use it, then there is a benefit for the community. And then we will produce also some resources to continue to develop the community.
I think that's the thing. If you have something that's for everybody, and then somebody is not using something because it's free, so it's taken for granted, it doesn't make sense. So for me, if we talk about free things, it's bad. I think the model where you can explain, like, wait, we have to do some certain action or participate, it doesn't have to be money, it's great, because it's exchange.
Great responsibility also.
Because in reality, then you would have empty space, which could be put in much better use. I mean, for everybody. So this is the logic behind.
It's a social innovation.
Yes.
It is. It's how to create a new model, so it's really sustainability, but not just sustainability in a financial sense. It's really about how to give and not just get what you're saying now from corporate. Do you have your all about business models? So do you have any suggestions for Elena?
No. Well, I say just to keep up a little bit with the good practices from that. We will say that one thing that we have learned through the development of the time is that you only have to manage what you can handle. So maybe suddenly you save the full work, but you can only handle this part of the right wing. So you start to say, okay, we are aiming to be this, but maybe we start by having a common experience, and after people will be joining, but you just manage what you can. So you make profit, you make it feel feasible, while in the way you can make it. And that's one of the things that have learned the team. Like, you delegate to the people, and the people will decide what they do, and you can always come back and knock the door and say, okay, how did you make it?
One really silly example is when I mentioned sponsorship. People are used to pay for beer, but they are not used to pay for education. So if you have sponsors with beer, they will pay for the beer, and that's something. I know this sounds stupid, but in reality, you have to understand how our minds operate. So if you can have good partners, I mean, it doesn't have to be beer. Anything else.
Why?
You can transfer that to the money. So it's money has to come to
something. Or you can just choose the occupy and serve arrangement philosophy. You make a nice party, you make money, and after you keep the other way around, but you make. You need to have the sponsor, you need to marry without the sponsor forever. Just make a party, like always book hardcore, dirty people, okay, money, and you give away a t-shirt, so I don't know if it's more for free, and they are used to pay for beers or for party.
Well, then you hear the internet
artists.
Yeah,
yeah. You know, yes, they're not
really lying.
In the beginning of the year, 18 years ago, they are a fleet with a lot of coats, wine and beer, and there is a boat, and okay, you can take something when you pesetas in that time. So we saw that people didn't pay, and we say, okay, we could take much as for the kind of time you pay there. But the thing is, maybe we have co-working spaces, but we have the lack of having other kind of places where we can make other things. And for example, we used to rent one big space for events, and in that case, it was where the enterprise are the people who pay for the rent, and those are the people who have money, not the entrepreneur normally. So in that moment, we take some money, and we have the bar also, so the bar will be a good option for that. And in that way, we'll start making people think that, okay, maybe we need to pay for a contract, or we need to pay for, I don't know, for the experience. Yeah? We have different activities. Of course, there are more people in once they are free, but there are people in once they need to pay. And in Spain, it's more or less the same. It's difficult to make people pay for the concert because it's the council who makes things free. So,
no, I want to completely disagree with the bar income. We had practicing the alcohol sales in our events. And now, since we don't have the bar to run the bar anymore, I'm much more happy and because it asks a lot of time and energy to run it, and to run it with really good to make it good income as all kind of businesses. So we don't waste time on doing that, but spend better time on trying to make this addiction of the people to something else, to those crazy things. For example, I mean, people are really liking different kind of addictions. I know some of my friends who can't stop smoking. That's a really strong addiction. But we have a lot of different addictions to a lot of different things, like also good movies is one of the addiction to the people. And I think what we have to do, if we are professionals in the culture field, we have to make new addictions to the people, to the culture products, not to the beer.
In our case, it's an
we thought that this will be a good income. We have done that, but now I don't.
It's only an auxiliary thing because you can create that third place. I mean, it's not only to go there and take a beer. It's to, when you finish your job in the co-working space, you can be there working with other people, enjoying the environment, the ecosystem, and maybe it's a place for networking also, or to create. I mean, it's not bad. It's an auxiliary service. It's there, but it's not our main service, of course.
If I can say something because it's connected to this, because our first thing, what we're trying now, for the last months to do, is to open a bar again. And, I think there are, but we really are thinking on some kind of community bar, you know? It's. The purpose of this bar is not only to earn money and that we die in this. It's also planned with the program inside and lots of workshops that will involve more community to take part of this future space. So, no, everybody likes to drink coffee, and it's stupid that we all from Rhodes every day go on the other side of the street and give money there, where we can give money here and make something with it. And we will drink coffee for sure. I think this is important. The program, the idea of this bar, how to create benefits.
I mean, this was my thought. It was not like you should fund your space based on sponsorship drinks, but it's really dependent on the culture. We have a strong coffee culture, so we spend every day pretty kunas for coffee and beer, but we will never spend that pretty kunas in one of these communities which has it's more about how people perceive certain things.
So maybe money is not bad, so you have to find a way to diversify your income, and I think this is a good way, or renting a space, or any other way that can keep the community, but also diversify the So we heard a lot about community creating products. What is your experience and what kind of products? And I always, in our case, we're thinking about the tourism, and you know, so tourism is one way of using the classical social cultural centers in a tourism way, so it can also bring income or more and keep the community. So what are you thinking? What kind of products can communities?
Well, when you create life in a neighborhood or in a building that it wasn't alive before, the only way to make it a tourism, I think, or a tourist place, is just keep on going for more than 1 year and a half, minimum. Every Sunday, for instance, if you make an activity during an amount of time at the same time, so you manage to make the place that we exist, and at some point, in the case of that, they became together with another activities in the neighborhood that gathered together to make it on Sundays. They became the place to go on Sundays. So the tourism are telling, hey, you have to go there on Sundays. And they have started to open local bars in the area that were completely closed. So
it's a way to revive the community.
But you are offering an experience because you have your political views of how you want to make things. How you use the spaces during the week and how you work makes a difference. And after, because you exist and you are persistent the same time, the same day, you make it happen and you become a reference. And this is what is happening around the world.
What do you think, Irena, in Troy? Can this happen?
To be honest, it can be, but we are a little bit afraid of it. Because we have in Pula the problem, not problem, I see it like a problem, because all our culture more and more is culture for tourists, and we are losing productions already lots of years, like a lot of people. But really, it's also in Rojas, it's like this. We produce a lot of things and we sell everything, all programs in the summer for tourists, just a little part for the local community. And so I'm a little bit scared of this, but also the idea of hostel that we are want to do, it goes in that direction. But I always say what I was saying, the same thing for Bar before. In this hostel, we want to implement the idea of artisan residence, to help this produce some other things, and until it goes in that direction, for me it's okay. Also, then to have, we will for sure in that moment have a bigger support of the town, of the touristic office of the town, but we need to be careful that this doesn't become the main thing for our whole life.
I think we shouldn't be afraid of tourists. Because it's not the same kind of tourism, you know.
Yeah, it's not a map.
In this place, you could have tourism during winter. You have no tourists during winter. You know. So it's a good opportunity to develop something different. It's what they did actually in Lisbon, I think. And with the X Factory, lots of restaurants. You have also a cooking space. You can learn how to cook traditional Portuguese food. And also you have residences for artists, but not only for artists, it's also for tourists. Because, you know, it's such a mixed model. It's not something for traditional tourists. It could be for co-worker, nomads worker.
Yeah.
Yes,
but
and it means something, we're talking about that for your application, Pula 2020. Because that's an opportunity to attract new people here.
And especially because of the cheap lights, I think. So
sorry, could you use the microphone? It's getting hard.
especially because of the cheap flights during the summer season. Okay, but it's a really good opportunity because you have a lot of people who pay their flight in the States $3,000, and it's better for them to spend it in Poland for 3 months to have a space, to have all this beauty of the city. So you should always think much wider than just how we have.
That's
what
I
wanted
to say. That, I think that this is what we were trying on Monday when we were listening our mayor and his speech, a speech about tourism in Pula. What we are all the time trying to explain to him that there are different kinds of tourism, and of course it's not something, but you know, there are parallel processes, different, and still, like, we need to see how this.
Yeah, I think we don't have to be afraid of tourism, not culture tourism, but of another tourists which we don't like, because actually this is also it's a benefit for us to reach those tourists which are citizens of the in the other countries. Which is also potential our audience, but just not living in Croatia but somewhere else. And of course, if Pula attracts more tourists, they would come, and they need some places where to go when they are here. And if they will be ended up here, and you can provide them something to think on. I think that you are doing a great thing for those uncultured tourists.
We are not against it. But just the point
but
is
you
just
want to change them.
No, it's not. It's the parallel things. You know, you need to create, for example, co-working space that you could bring these kind of tourists. That's why we need to be careful. Just this. Because it's not the first time it could happen, because already happened that buildings like this, with little hostel inside, after they started to produce the money with the hostel, and here the owner is Pula, and like we are just one association using this building, the management of the building doesn't really exist. So you know, there is, we don't, yes, just a little bit of attention that we don't have. Okay, now we have hostel, now we will build the main point for tourists, and start slowly, everything starts to die because of it. I'm just pointing a little bit on
well,
this.
Yeah, it's not
because,
so extreme, I think
yes,
there's
yes.
Definitely ways in between, and by the definition, tourist is everybody who spends more than two nights in the city, so it's not just the tourists with St. Olsen and white socks that come.
It's just about creating parallel programs, so you know you can have one nice circle of it.
I just want very, very, very much to support your critical attitude, because I think it's extremely important. Now, coming back to Fred in the morning, your presentation, also anarchistic perception of everything. I'm sorry. I'm a bit anti-commercial, same as you. I am very critical about tourism. It destroys culture constantly. And if we are looking on, like, take my personal attitude away, but if we're looking on Lloyd's and what you have created here, and you have created not only a third space, to my mind, you created heterotopia, and it's absolute, I mean, sorry, it's getting philosophic, you created heterotopia. Foucault, perhaps some of us. Heterotopia is the place which is not topos, here and now, which is not dystopia, like something that is like affecting us in a negative way, but heterotopia is some third place in a way. So for example, Foucault defined heterotopia as a museum, as an education institution, maybe, but that again has a purpose. That you can be somewhere without a real purpose. You're just enjoying the environment. You're just there. Graveyards are famous for that. A graveyard is not very much a commercial issue. I mean, in the US sometimes, in LA. Okay. But generally, our European perception is not really. And I think we need tourism logically. We need to steer it logically. But if I look on Lloyds, which has created for me something, a really valuable heterotopian space, then I would be very afraid if you start without this critical attitude. For sure, you probably do start something, but to keep your critical attitude and carefully observe, and not every cultural institution immediately has to be so-called creative industries. I'm sorry, I hate this term. It's really fucked up. There's no other word for it. And to be very careful about who you are, what do you really want, and nobody else around you, like in the city, cultural development agencies, whatsoever, steering you in something, but you decide, you have the ownership here. Keep that. However you decide, that's another question.
Thank you. I think we needed this perspective as well. Sorry, but Mattia was before. And we have Daniela Tomba, we have one minute or something, so maybe just to wrap up.
Before your intervention, suddenly I realized that the important key thing is that, claro, you don't have the space. It's not yours. It's not a Thab's case that they have booked the place, so they own that place, so they can decide what kind of philosophy is behind the hostel. Claro, so then I realize, ah, claro, you are having day inside your house. So that's the key thing, like if suddenly you have the hostel is not built by your resources and it's not built slowly with intervention of artists that are going to build the atmosphere of the heterotopia philosophy and happy place and cool place to be.
It's not so difficult,
but claro, that's the key thing. So maybe it's not about the hostel, it's okay, but maybe it's it will take 3 years and it will take people to do it and not the public institution, but if they don't give you the permit, you know, to do it, maybe that's the luck. So you guys say, okay, we don't want your money, we just want the permit to make it happen. And it will take long term, but you will have your own management of the space. For us it's super weird that you all have the space is for the government, that you cannot decide on it. Claro, you don't pay for it, but you are paying it in selling your philosophies and your views. So maybe it's about saying, okay, get your public space for you, and we have to talk with private owners. I don't know, eh? But that's something about
the strategy that they need to decide. Mattia was waiting.
Well, I just wanted to close out a little bit. Like three weeks ago, I was in Utrecht, and there is a really interesting model which is involving, so it's a really big co-working space, but the interesting thing is that you don't pay for it. So when you're using open space, you don't pay for it, you get free coffee and you get free lunch every day. Exactly. So in our mind, it's
stick to meat.
Yeah, so in our mind, the question is how is that even possible? Because it costs so much. And when you talk to them, they say, but what our product or our business is serendipity, basically. So what we do is creating meaningful connections. So basically, their members, when you talk to them, they are wondering how come we don't have to pay for it because we want to pay for it. So because they are paying back with participating in all the programs they do. So basically, it's from booking to every other event. So I think for us that's like hyperspace, you know, it's really strange for us. But you have examples which are really amazing. I mean, it costs a lot and we have to find that X ingredient, how they pull it off. But in reality, I think co-working is about serendipity. You know, how can you connect to the right people and make your life meaningful as possible and to realize your own potential. That's about it. It's unknown, but it's happening.
Thank you. Do you have some final thoughts on this? Although it's going to be hard to beat this.
Just coming back to the association, when I came here the first time, I discovered you don't have so many members of an association, which is the same actually in Darwin. We have an association. And at the beginning, I couldn't understand why people are in a collective place and they don't have members. But I think we could think about that, because it's a way to get to know people and maybe to have them more involved in the life of the place. And maybe they could find some solutions, get some money, but in a collective way. My thoughts.
Okay, some final thoughts on the issue of the community sharing networking. How to sustain again the community and how to attract also the communities that don't usually, you don't even think about maybe communicating with them anymore.
Come on, this is very easy. You need a common enemy.
You mean the city, right?
Get a common enemy, you find an enemy, you know, and that way you can come together.
Well, I'm afraid I started something.
you can just gather together, because I was thinking, you don't gather together for money, you make business. So you say, you find the enemy. So you can find some people that they need to, you know how you say, attack the ceiling holes. So you will have for a while some people working on that, autonomously.
Yeah.
After you have the rats, so you have all the bugs in the basement gathered together to be the rats thing, whatever, whatever. Okay. So you have to find the common enemy.
What do you think?
Me?
Do you agree on the public enemy?
Yeah. In the reading of the spaces, we have made one sentence that is we have in common more than separate us. So you need to look for them. And always is something that meet together. I mean, it's maybe utopia, but it's not.
You got a lot of ideas today.
it happened. We had a common enemy twice when we were all united. First time when our big parking in front was the city tried to put it under payment, and we were all against, and we made a big protest, I don't know, 6 years ago. And we were all together. The second time was when the town wanted to start
paying the rent.
That we pay the rent. So, but I think there are lots of different ways that we can involve community, and it's always this, we are talking community, how to involve, we are community. And I think this, we had one great workshop in March, when Martin Simon from Great Britain came, and he worked with us to start not to think so much on the problems and how and blah blah, but to think more what are the potential of the community that we can use and how to take them and it was really, we really learned a lot on this workshop when we were thinking about community. In our projects, the future project, there is like urban garden that lots of people are already interested in, to make it here up. And this is one of the way, it's not only about the money, it's really how also here, like people bring in the winter time, it's very cold in the corridors, and parents bring their children to the activities, and then they have like 2 hours of waiting. They come here, and then you start to have here a different, totally different people that usually were afraid of roads, or it was not really good for them, but. So there are different ways how we can involve community, and I say on the end, we are also part of the community.
Okay, final thoughts, Kasper?
A reaction to the community. In our experience with the Darwinia, at the beginning we created some committees to think about different issues like ecological transition in Darwin, cooperation, well-being. It was very good at the beginning to create, for example, yoga sessions, lots of activities. But after a while, it didn't work so much. This committee was boring. Nobody came, or I don't know. And now what we've noticed, it's important to have projects, concrete projects. We can organize a workshop with a creative method to create connections, complementary skills, interests, to build common projects. It's very, very concrete. And something else we organized recently, it's a new experience, it's how we can share skills. I can discover what your skills, what are your skills, it could be personal skills or be very professional. And it's something to do with the time then. That's something we saw in our interview recently. It's something we back up, back of time, relation with skills. I think that's a good way to make connection between the organization and the voice.
Alex Gilman was mentioned today. I think their logic is perfect. You shouldn't think of community as some other side. It's you and everybody who converts to this mindset. So it's not about how can you be applied to everybody else, but how can you create people who are proactive and they will do it themselves. Because that you will enjoy your day and not be like a servant to everybody else. So I think the message is about that, not about being polite.
Well, from my experience, the very good community gathering activities were doing events were like to part all the tenants of the spaces. I don't know if you have that like once a year with all the open doors and this and so it's very good way of doing.
Okay, I think we're out of time, right? We're way out of time. So I'd like to thank you all for your great ideas and experiences.